Dear viewers, if you are an NRI and if you have an income in India, it is subjected to the slab rate which is applicable in India. But in this particular case, there can be an exception to the rule. If your income comes from the interest earned on your fixed deposits from NRO accounts, or if your income is coming from dividends, then you have something to rejoice here. Under the DTAA agreement, Double Tax Avoidance Agreement, you can claim a lesser rate of income tax to be paid in India. In this episode, we are going to discuss how you can make best use of this DTA agreement to pay lesser taxes in India. This is NRI Money Clinic for you, and I am Dr. Chandrakant Bhatt, investment consultant and a financial planner.
NRI Money Clinic, no hype. Just the right advice.
Dear viewers, to talk about how you can reduce your income tax burden with respect to the interest that you have earned in India or with respect to the dividends that you have got from your investments in India, I have brought to the studios my eminent faculty, Chartered Accountant Sriram. Chartered Accountant Sriram is familiar face to you all. He is a specialist in international direct taxation, a partner at NitinJShetty.com, a man who has to his credit solving several tax queries of high net worth individuals across the globe. Welcome to the show, Sri Sriram.
Thank you.
Mr. Sriram, can you briefly tell, if an NRI has got income in India, what is the normal way they get taxed? I mean, the slab rates, what is that applicable? And thereafter, let's see how we can help them reduce their tax burden with respect to interest and the dividends.
Now, there are under Income Tax Act, it's not only applicable to NRIs as such in specific. There are certain incomes, say capital gains and say some other lottery incomes, etc., which are taxable at a specific rate.
Okay.
There are certain other incomes which are taxable at a slab rate.
Okay.
So, similar provisions are applicable to non-residents also.
Okay.
But with some exceptions. Say, for non-resident, in some cases, there are some incomes which are taxable at flat rates again.
Okay.
Okay. So, in respect of interest, if any interest income is earned by a non-resident, the same is taxable at slab rate. There is no specific rate as such on any of the interest income earned.
Okay.
By a non-resident or even for that matter resident.
Let me understand with this with the help of an example. Now let's say that I have an income of 40 lakh rupees income per year in India. Just okay. An assumption.
Okay.
Out of this, 10 lakhs comes from my gains from mutual fund investment, capital gains. Now that capital gains has nothing to do with the slab rate.
Correct.
So it follows a fixed rate of taxation.
Yes.
Out of the remaining 30 lakhs, let's say 15 lakhs comes from the interest income alone.
Correct.
Okay. So in the normal course of time, so this will attract about 1/3, 33% as the slab rate.
Correct.
Which is applicable.
Yes.
If somebody has less than 5 lakh, there could be a different slab, or if somebody has 15 lakh, he has may have a different slab rate.
Correct.
The maximum tax slab under that category is 33% plus applicable cess and other things will also follow.
30% plus
cess will follow.
Yes.
Correct? Right.
Yes.
Now my question is, for NRIs, if their major income comes from interest, which could be NRE, FDs or whichever the other interest sources within India, and a substantial amount of money also gets added as an income from the dividends received from their investment in the Indian companies. Now, as per the total slab structure, they have to pay 30% tax plus cess or whatever is that maximum tax slab. My question is there a way wherein which an NRI can pay less taxes on this interest and dividends that they have earned?
Yes. Now, in the hands of NRIs, as you rightly said, interest is taxable at slab rates. So, whereas the dividend as such, if the dividend by an NRI earned from an Indian company, that is taxable at 20% plus surcharge and education cess as applicable.
Huh. So dividend is maximum is 20%.
20%. So okay. There is a specific special rate for dividends as such.
Okay.
But to that again surcharge and education cess is added.
Okay.
So surcharge again may vary from 0 to 37%. Hence the rate of tax on dividend also may vary from 20.8% to 28.5%.
Okay.
It is the one kind of depending on the quantum of dividend what he earns, it depends on that the rate of tax may vary.
Okay.
So there is a way to reduce these tax liabilities.
Okay.
So now say for example if he is earning very high rate of interest, I mean high interest, then the rate may be 30% plus education cess or surcharge as applicable. Dividend is 28.5% maybe.
Okay.
So can he reduce? Yes, he can reduce.
Okay.
But he might have to resort to double taxation avoidance agreement, meaning thereby if he is a non-resident in India, he would be resident in some other country.
Correct.
In the country in which he is a resident, with that particular country, if India has a double taxation avoidance agreement,
I think India has signed with DTA with
most countries. More than 96 countries, almost 100 countries they have signed a double taxation avoidance agreement.
Okay.
So with almost all the countries, in respect of interest and dividends, there are specific rate of taxes which is applicable for the non-resident in a country wherein this interest or dividend is sourced.
Okay.
So invariably these rate of taxes on interest and dividends will be much lesser than these higher slab rates.
Okay.
And especially say for example if it is a Gulf country, it the rate of interest tax on the interest and dividend may vary from 5% to say 12.5%. If it is say for example UK or US or even Canada, Netherlands, again the rate of dividend tax on the dividend may be varying from 5% to 20-25%. Sometimes it may be less than what is the rate of tax applicable under the domestic provisions.
Okay. So if I understood you correctly, now for an NRI, if he lives in a one country and if that country has signed a DTAA agreement with India.
Correct.
So that agreement will clearly specify what could be the maximum tax slab applicable with respect to interest that you have earned in India as correct. Well as the dividends that you have earned in India.
Correct.
Now if you are an NRI and because of your total income and you come under a higher slab like 30% and cess, in that case if you use the DTAA agreement provisions, you are liable to pay a lesser taxes than the maximum tax slab which is otherwise would have been applicable for you in India. Now this slab varies from country to country.
Correct.
And whichever the country you are staying there, you have to look into the provisions of DTAA agreements.
Correct.
As per Mr. Sriram, so most of these countries have the provisions and the tax slab under those DTAA agreement is much lower than the biggest tax slab which is applicable in India at the moment.
Correct.
So if somebody is having paying a lesser amount of tax, if he is already in a non-tax slab or if he is having a lower tax slab, you don't have to really worry about.
Correct.
But if you are a person who is taxed to the highest because of this interest earned or the dividends earned, then you have a helping hand in DTAA agreements.
Correct.
Look for that, find out what could be the tax structure, and based on that you can apply for exemptions under DTAA and you can pay lesser amount of taxes on your interest as well as the dividends income in India.
Correct.
Right?
Yes.
Okay. So it's just not possible for us to tell you exactly what could be the thing, but can you tell me what could be the normal range you have seen under different DTAA agreement, what could be the maximum tax slabs that you have seen?
See, it varies from around 5% to 25%.
Okay. So here the maximum can be 30% plus surcharge, but whereas under DTAA it could be
25% maximum, and it may not be the same.
Okay.
And some are like unconditional or with some small conditions.
Okay.
Say for example if it is Saudi Arabia, if you are a resident of Saudi Arabia, then on dividends earned, income earned in India, the rate of tax in India would be only 5%.
So it's as low as 5%?
Yes.
Okay.
And say for example you are in UAE, the rate of tax on the interest earned maybe as less as 12.5%.
Okay.
And whereas, you know, if you are earning income from interest, which is, you know, more than 5 lakhs, in India, there is a, you know, tax rate of 20%. So, it is anyway be less than that.
Okay.
So, you can look into those provisions.
So, it's a differential rate and it is a favorable tax which is applicable to NRIs
and,
in this particular case.
And in some matters, say for example, in the case of say US or say in the case of say Canada, on the dividend, the rate of tax may be 25%.
Hmm.
So, there are possibilities that it may be other way around also.
Okay. Mr. Sriram, now you said under DTAA, the interest earned and the dividends can be treated in a differential way, right?
Correct.
But there can be other sources of income like salaries that they would have earned or something else. Will DTAA cover that also, or is there a differential tax structure, or this is only restricted to interest and dividend income?
See, normally the DTAA structure will be like this. There are four types of income: interest, dividend, royalty and fees for technical services.
Okay.
On these four types of income, there will be specific rate of taxes.
Okay.
Under double taxation avoidance agreement.
Okay.
Any other type of income or any other nature of income, normally the double taxation avoidance agreement would tell that whatever the rate of tax applicable, as applicable in the country of the source of that income, will apply to that particular income.
Okay.
So, there will not be specific rate of tax for say salary, capital gains or rental income,
etc. That will follow the usual taxation pattern.
Yes.
The differential rate of taxation is with respect to interest, dividend, royalties and the technical services.
Yes.
Which will be mentioned in the DTAA agreement.
Yes.
Okay. Mr. Sriram, now DTAA gives the benefit of lowered tax rate with respect to interest and dividend, you said.
Correct.
If that is the case, what happens to this cess and other levies which we normally pay with a slab rate? Do we still have to pay cess, or because it is DTAA, a flat rate applies there?
See, the rate which is fixed under double taxation avoidance agreement are fixed by two sovereign countries. You know, it's a between an agreement between two countries. So, it is not a unilateral approach. There's a it's actually bilateral approach. So, when such a rate is fixed, that is over and above the domestic law provisions.
Okay.
So, being that the case, the rate which is fixed under double taxation avoidance agreement is free from application of cess and surcharge.
So, there are two benefits for an NRI.
Correct.
Here now.
Correct.
One, if you are eligible under DTAA, a relaxation in the rate.
Correct.
That rate applies.
Correct.
And you are don't have to pay cess and other
surcharge
levies.
Yes.
Extra. So, the finally what you have to pay is the rate which is mentioned in the DTA agreement for that particular heading.
Correct.
Under which the income is categorized.
Correct.
So, there is a dual benefit in this.
Correct.
Right. Mr. Sriram, that brings to my mind one more question. An NRI is living in one corner of the world, and that country where he lives has signed an agreement with India, DTAA. Mm. Now, is it an obligation for an NRI to use the provisions of DTAA, or it is left to him either to take refuge under that or to pay taxes in a normal way? Yeah, is there an obligation?
There is no obligation as such. It's purely optional.
Okay.
Again, it is optional, say, qua income. Meaning thereby, say for example, if you take United States, okay, the rate of tax on dividend is as high as 25%, whereas under the Indian Income Tax Act is 20.8%.
Okay.
So, whereas the rate of tax on interest earned by a resident of US is 15%, whereas slab rate might go up to 30%.
Okay.
So, there is a difference here. So, now NRI who is a resident of US may opt to pay the taxes in India on the dividend income earned as per the Indian domestic law. Okay, it's purely optional. And at the same time, in the same year, on the interest, he can opt to pay the taxes as per DTAA.
Okay.
That is also possible.
Okay.
So, whichever is beneficial for him, that he can adopt.
Okay, so there is no obligation. So,
no.
If you are NRI living in some part of the world, It is purely left to your discretion whether should you invoke the provisions of DTAA to your benefit. If not, if you are not already taxed, then yes, you can just forget and you can file the tax returns as the normal case may be.
Yes.
It's left to your discretion what you want to do it. There is no obligation to use DTAA.
Correct, sir.
Now that a NRI decides to make a claim under DTAA provisions, a differential rate of taxation for him, what kind of a documentation will follow? What evidence he has to give to the tax authorities to say that he lives in a particular country and eligible to make claims under this DTAA provisions?
As per Income Tax Act, there is a requirement of production of tax residency certificate.
TRC.
TRC.
Okay.
In short form we say
TRC.
TRC. This is a certificate which that particular person who is saying that I am not resident of India, but I am resident of say UAE or say US or UK, whatever the country it may be, from that particular country's federal tax authorities, he has to obtain this certificate in which that federal tax authority would certify that this particular person having passport number or so and so is a resident of that particular country for a particular period.
Okay.
So it is called as a TRC, okay, tax residency certificate.
Okay.
This is a must.
Okay.
To obtain the benefit of double taxation avoidance agreement.
Right.
Apart from that, there is a one simple form, form 10F we call, under income tax provision, that also needs to be submitted, and that needs to be kept in hand so that he can avail the benefit of double taxation avoidance agreement benefits.
Okay. Now you said that documentary evidence which is required. One question that comes to my mind is, now for NRIs, TDS is bit harsh. TDS is collected the highest rate.
Correct.
Now if somebody has got a tax residence certificate, TRC, or makes a claim under DTAA, now can he claim for a differential TDS because he is not eligible to pay the full rate of taxation? Does he have liberty to request that my TDS be at a lesser rate as governed by DTAA?
Yes, possible. Provided before the deduction of TDS, that particular person obtains a TRC and produces it before the deductor. Say for example, it may be a bank where he has kept FD in NRO deposit. So to the banker, he need to provide this TRC along with Form 10F before the deduction of TDS on such NRO interest as such. So at that point in time, the banker would be obligated to deduct TDS at a very lower rate. But it is again left to the country of residence to provide the TRC. Some countries may not be willing to provide the TRC during the, you know,
The beginning of the year itself.
Yes.
Correct.
Yes. Or some countries like say US, which taxes its own residents who are citizen of US on residence basis, they may provide the TRC at the beginning of the year itself.
Yeah, I have heard in Dubai and all, if you have to get a TRC, you have to prove that you have lived for so many number of days in
Correct.
A financial year.
Correct.
So it may be difficult for people to apply for a TRC in the beginning of the year.
Yes.
So that gives me one more doubt in my mind. Now an NRI has so much of an interest income and a large TDS has been collected already.
Correct.
But at the time of assessment, he produces a TRC. Now can that extra tax which is deducted by way of an additional TDS done, can it be claimed back because he gives a TRC?
Yes, it is possible, very much possible. He can either adjust that tax against any other tax liability which he has to pay.
Okay.
Or he can claim it as a refund by filing the return of income. If the taxes what he needs to pay in India is lesser than the TDS which is already been deducted on his account.
Okay.
So refund is possible, no issues.
So if somebody is prepared to give a TRC in the beginning of the year and gives it to the concerned a bank or institution which is supposed to do a TDS, then they can deduct a TDS at a differential rate as mandated under your DTAA agreement.
Correct.
But if you cannot produce that and a large TDS has already been applied on your earnings, then at the time of filing your tax returns, you can make a claim based on the documentation that you have provided for exemptions under the DTAA agreement.
Correct.
Mr. Sriram, a large number of NRIs live in the Gulf countries.
Correct.
And in these Gulf countries, there is no personal income tax.
Correct.
There is no taxes there. If it is UK, Canada, Ireland, all these places, there is a personal taxation.
Correct.
Now, these NRIs who live in these countries where there is no personal taxation which is involved, is it possible for them to get a tax residency certificate there also?
Yes, it is possible. Because our own clients have got tax residency certificate from federal tax authorities from UAE.
Okay.
Or some years back, I also remember that one of our clients got TRC from Kuwait, the
okay.
Ministry of Finance from Kuwait.
Okay.
So it is possible. I mean, out of 7 Gulf countries, India has DTA with 5 Gulf countries, except for Bahrain and Iraq. We have DTA with all the other countries.
Mm-hmm.
So it is possible to get TRC as required to claim the DTA benefits.
Okay.
From right. those countries also, no right. issues.
So dear viewers, so if you are an NRI and if you stand to get benefited from using the DTAA provisions to your favor, please look into the possibility of applying for tax residency certificate in the country in which you are living. That may be probably the best thing that you can think of if you have to reduce your tax burden in India. At the same time, look out for the cost for getting a TRC certificate in your country. If you have a very small tax burden in India, and to save on that, if you have to spend a large amount of money to get a TRC in your country, it doesn't make any sense. Weigh the options, see what is beneficial for you, and finally be guided by what would be the most beneficial thing for you to pursue on. Mr. Sriram, thank you very much for bringing all these inputs for the benefits of our viewers. I'm very sure a large number of NRIs will watch this episode and get benefited from the information that is given to you. Thank you very much for all these inputs.
You're welcome, sir.
Dear viewers, the content that we have presented to you in this video, if it helped you to get an idea about how you can reduce your tax burden with respect to the interest that you have earned in India or the dividends that you have earned in India, please like this video. If you are a person who is watching this channel for the first time, or if you are yet to subscribe for this channel, please hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon. Don't forget to share this video with your friends and relatives. Thank you very much for watching this episode on NRI Money Clinic. I shall be back with you with yet another topic in yet another video very, very soon.
Press the bell icon for more details and subscribe our channel.